I'm very pleased to be here today. My name is Henrik Carlsen, and as Tim said, I'm head of Department of Mechanical Engineering at Technical University of Denmark. And I'll make a short introduction to our new maritime center at DTU. Denmark has a strong position internationally in the maritime sector, and shipping represents a significant part of this. But new challenges, strong competition, make a new freight conditions, and energy prices increasing, fluctuating, and overcapacity, although decreasing, that actually also adds up to new regulations and requirements for emissions on SOx and NOx. Particulate matters and ballast water regulations, and also of course this will give new demand for new ships, but also a large actually task in adapting existing ships by retrofitting to the new frame conditions. An important part of the mission of DTU is to be to the benefit of society, and of course DTU has an obligation and also definitely an interest to support the Blue Denmark to keep their international position, which is also stated in the growth plan for the Blue Denmark. And DTU, just shortly, about 9,000, more than 9,000 students, and 4,100 employees just now. One from those, 1,800 is scientific staff. We have nearly 1,200 PhD students, as they actually also are staff. They should be added to the two other numbers. We have a number of educations in Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Engineering, more known in Denmark as diploma engineers, and master science programs. And the whole university is divided in 20 departments. It's therefore, in order to roll out, therefore natural that DTU goes into this and try to establish a maritime center to support the recommendations in the growth plan for Blue Denmark and make focus on research and education, and definitely on interdisciplinarity, strengthen innovation, and of course cooperation with the industry, also strengthen cooperation with our colleague university in Denmark. We have already established a close cooperation to CBS and also SDU, and internationally we already have connections with some of the very strong universities in the world, including especially KAIST in Korea. The organization of the new center, it is actually an initiative by the management of DTU, and it has a strong support from the management. This is very important. And all relevant researchers at the whole DTU is actually invited. DTU Mechanical Engineering, where my head of department is hosting the center, but it's more or less a center without walls. Although there will be a possibility to sit together at our department. We have made a steering committee, actually represented by the three head of departments from the most active departments, that is DTU Transport and DTU Mechanical Engineering. And then there are three professors actually from representing those three departments in order to have responsibility from the strategy. And then we have an ongoing recruitment for head of the center, and this is not be, say, head a leader in the ordinary sense, but this will more be a leader who are going to facilitate and coordinate the activities. The new head of the center will not have responsibility for employees, but are actually trying to continue the work which has already been started. The center is actually also a natural consequence of that there was made a survey in 2011, actually made by ATV and supported by the Danish Maritime Fund. And this was to see what is the need for education in Denmark. And an important conclusion for us was that there is a lack of engineers in the Danish maritime sector. And often when you talk to companies in Denmark, they say that a restriction in order to expand the activities is actually lack of engineers. And those engineers should have a combination of say strong professional skills and also be able to act in an interdisciplinary way. And that is what we call the T-shaped engineer, actually illustrated by this multi-purpose knife. So you have the strong vertical professional skills, and then the more interdisciplinary skills on top, so you are able to act in and cooperate with at a broad sense. The new initiatives have until now resulted in that we have established new study plans in the maritime technology in actually all types, Bachelor of Engineering, Bachelor of Science, and Master of Science in Mechanical Engineering, where you can actually follow this study plan and then get better prepared for a professional life in the maritime sector. We have a new study line in maritime logistics, and a Master of Science education in transportation and logistics. And then we have a special course in Arctic operation, which will also is regarded to be important in the future. And then we have a new graduate course in green transportation logistics offered by DTU Transport. And then another initiative, actually a few years ago, the first Nordic Master was actually offered in maritime engineering. This is a cooperation in what we call Nordic 5 Tech, which is a cooperation between five of the technical universities in Scandinavia. Research, of course, we have activities brought over in green shipping, and the technology part is more efficient. Engines, for example, have close cooperation to man, diesel and turbo, better hull design, and so on. Also on the logistic side, we have many activities at transport management engineering, route net design, etc. And not that you are going to read all the details here, but you can see it's actually 11 departments at the center who are doing research in topics which are relevant to the maritime sector. And the Polar Center is also important in the future with the Arctic activities. And a lot of projects have been started, and these are examples by projects which actually the information can be found on the web, and they have been supported by the Danish Maritime Fund. But this is just to show that a lot is going on. Finally, what is the status of the center? We have a strong support from the industry. We have got a significant more maritime students now. 125 are members of a group, an organization made to connect the maritime students. We have got very successful excursions. Of course, we have had nationally, but now we have also Norway and here recently in Singapore. We have a lot of focus on interdisciplinarity. New research projects started, and as you know, the InnoPlus have led into this partnership, focusing on the maritime sector. And then here recently, ITU will host the International Symposium of Practical Design of Ships and Other Floating Structures, called PRAD, in 2016. So I'm looking forward to see the Maritime Center at DTU as a single point of organization, of contact, where people inside DTU can go and outside DTU can contact and get information on what is going on and establish new corporations in order to support the Danish maritime industry. Thank you.